Welcome to our live stream on Talk Shop Live. I'm so excited to be here with my partner in crime, Kimla Yingling of Eaton Asian, check out her blog, it's fabulous. But we're really happy to be here because it's the Boulevard Kitchen's third anniversary, and if you haven't been here before, the Boulevard Kitchen's in Sherman Oaks.
Yes.
We're at Woodman and Ventura, it's a cooking school. I happen to be an instructor here. But there's loads of classes for adults, for kids, for moms,
yes,
for dads, for teenagers, so please check it out. I'm teaching a dumpling class actually in July, so we felt like in honor of my upcoming class, we should teach everyone how to make pot stickers.
Yep.
But not only that, we are selling my cookbook, Everyday Chinese Cookbook, 101 delicious recipes from my mother's kitchen, today on Talk Shop Live. For $24, including shipping, which is an amazing price. You know why? Because it retails for $24.99. So you can get this for $24, including shipping, and the first 10 people to purchase my book, I will actually personalize the book.
Yes.
I'll make it out to your mom, to your girlfriend, to your boyfriend, to your brother, whatever. I will personalize it. I'll send it off, and it's only $24, including shipping. So all you have to do is press the buy button, right?
Yes.
Press the five button, press the five button. Okay, so this recipe is super easy. It's really fast. All of the ingredients that we're using today in these pot stickers you can buy at the regular grocery store. So we have some ground chicken
right here. Nice.
But you could use some ground pork if you wanted to. Also, to this we're gonna add a little bit of dry white wine. Of course I had to taste it before I poured it into this little bowl.
Of course.
Along with some sesame oil. Now, in Asian cooking, look for dark or toasted sesame oil. When cooking Asian dishes, always look for toasted or dark sesame oil. It has that great nutty aroma.
Oh, wow.
It smells so good. Then we just have a bit of cornstarch. This is gonna make the filling, the protein, nice and moist and juicy and delicious. And then just a bit of salt and pepper, that's it. It's super easy. But also we also have some Napa cabbage, so I'm gonna have Kim Lai shred a bit of this, like maybe this much.
Okay, that's it?
Just shred that up. Napa cabbage is similar to cabbage, but it's a little mellower. It's nice, it's such a sharp taste. And yeah, that would be great.
Okay.
Does anybody out there know why Napa cabbage is called Napa cabbage?
Because it's from Napa?
Ding, 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 ding.
Oh wait, is that real?
It's real.
Oh.
Well, actually, Napa cabbage has been cultivated for thousands of years. However, it was first cultivated in North America in Napa Valley.
Isn't that cool? Nice.
So you can find Napa cabbage, also known as Savoy cabbage, in the regular grocery store. But you can substitute with regular plain old garden variety cabbage if you wanted to.
Do you need this?
Excellent.
A little more?
That's awesome. So now we're going to just put cabbage in a bowl, like so.
Okay.
And then what we're gonna do is add a bit of salt. You wanna toss the cabbage into salt, that would be great.
Yes.
Okay. So what the salt does is it sweats the cabbage, it releases the moisture. We're just gonna let it sit for a minute or so, and then I'm gonna put it in just a dish towel. And if you've ever made latkes, some people do this when they're making latkes, they sweat the potatoes so the moisture comes out. Otherwise, it's gonna come out while it's cooking.
Not good.
You'll have soggy dumplings. And nobody wants soggy dumplings. Now, I'm Chinese American, and Kim Lai is Vietnamese
American.
So, what kind of dumplings do you eat in Vietnamese cuisine?
A lot of our dumplings are always pork. And then we use the wonton wraps, very similar to what you're doing here, but pork. But I know we use ground chicken sometimes too, so I would say very similar. And the only thing that's really different are the sauces.
Mm.
So we'll either add a hoisin or an oyster sauce to it. But other than that, we're using the very similar ingredients.
So what's great about dumplings is you can be super creative, right?
Yeah.
Put veggies in there, mushrooms, tofu, whatever.
Mushrooms.
Okay, so now that this is sitting here for a little bit, I'm just gonna put the cabbage in the dish towel.
Okay. Is that a wet towel or a dry towel?
Tina wanted to know if this was a wet towel or a dry towel. This is a dry towel because we're gonna be squeezing the moisture out of the cabbage. Now it's not like water's gonna come gushing out, but we're gonna release a bit of moisture. So I want Kim Lai to use her big strong muscles.
Oh.
She works out a lot more than I do.
just that's just, not good then, because it's never. Okay.
Yeah. So, like I said, it's not going to come pushing out, but we want some moisture to be released.
I can feel it's wet. I can feel the towel is wet. That's
all right.
But maybe no drippy drops.
No drippy drops.
Okay.
So, to our brown chicken, we're going to add our shredded cabbage.
Okay.
And we sweat it
ready?
Out. Excellent.
Okay.
Good job.
Thank you.
Then I'm going to add some sesame oil, the white wine, cornstarch,
okay,
and a bit of chopped scallions. Now maybe a little salt. Now we eat these for Chinese New Year, for Vietnamese New Year, Lunar New Year. Do you also make dumplings? Because for us, it symbolizes prosperity.
Noodles, a lot of noodles.
For long life.
But I know there are certain kind of dumplings that are for Tet. Mm-hmm. But I eat dumplings all throughout the year.
They're delicious every day of the year. Okay.
Okay.
All right, so you don't mind, you want to mix this together with a spoon? Great. The great thing about these dumplings is you can make them ahead of time, but what I like to do is I fold the dumplings, I make the little pleats, I put them on a cookie sheet individually, put it in the freezer, allow the dumplings to freeze completely beforehand, then I put them in a Ziploc bag. If you put them in all together to bake first, they're going to stick together.
This smells so good.
Does it smell good?
Yes.
What I also love about this filling is you can use it many different ways. So think about it, you have one filling you can use three different ways. You can make a pot sticker, you can stick it in a wonton and make a wonton shape, which she can show you in a minute. Drop that in some boiling broth and make wonton soup.
Yes.
Or in some hot oil and have a crispy wonton. Or as Kim Lai was just saying, shumai, which is everybody's favorite.
That's like a dumpling too, though.
Steamed dumpling. Yeah. Anyway, totally versatile, right?
Yes.
Okay, so. Did your mom teach you how to make pot stickers?
No. No. But YouTube did.
I love it.
She taught me to make wontons.
That's
sort of.
Well, what she always taught me is, I'm just putting about, I don't have a little spoon right now. I'm just putting in about a teaspoon of the filling in the middle here. But what she taught me is, no matter what your dumplings look like, they're going to taste delicious. Because people get intimidated by making pleats, don't you think?
Yeah, absolutely.
So then I'm just going to take a bit of
water. She taught you a trick?
Yeah. Now, do you want to do the same thing as I?
Yes, of course.
There you go.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. So, the basic way to make a pot sticker is just to do a half moon shape and seal it like so, right? But you kind of want a flat bottom, because they're called pot stickers, because they stick to the bottom of the panel a bit. So if you're feeling intimidated and you're a newbie, just go with a half moon shape.
Okay, so perfect.
Okay.
And you do this to seal the edges.
Okay, so this is the basic dumplings for beginners method, okay?
Yes.
I'm going
to
move on.
Get these noodles
The wrappers are available at any grocery store. You can find them where you buy the tofu. Yeah, that's it. But you can buy some wrappers, which is great as well. Okay, so again, I'm going to moisten the top edge of the dumpling wrapper. And they're called pot sticker wrappers. Sometimes they're called wonton wrappers. If they're square, you can cut the edges off like my daughter Becky did for us today. She just used a scissor and she made a round shape. Okay, now I'm just gonna take the moistened part of the wrapper. I'm gonna twist it and I'm going to seal it with a flat part of the wrapper. So I'm just gonna twist and press.
I'm gonna open that back up.
We're just gonna twist. Oh, it's a pinching.
Pressing.
You're doing great. You're doing great.
That goes in.
It's a pitching, pressing action. Should we do another one?
So that's the difference between a dumpling and a pot sticker, literally.
Well, a dumpling is like an umbrella term.
So are these?
Yeah.
So this is like
a lot of these are dumplings.
This is a form of a dumpling.
See? Like this is technically a dumpling.
So shumai is always a good job, Kim. No matter what your dumplings look like, they're always going to taste
dumpling
delicious.
Fails.
Oh.
but we have some people
gonna taste delicious. But they're still gonna taste delicious.
And we have people saying hello and welcome. It's so great to see you back on, Katie.
Aww, who's out there?
Brian and Jennifer.
Hi, Brian and Jennifer. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna moisten it. Let's just do this one more time for our fans. Okay, I'm gonna twist the moistened part of the wrapper and I'm gonna press. This recipe is in my cookbook, Everyday Chinese Cookbook, available today for $24, including shipping. And I'll even sign it for you if you're one of the first 10 people to buy. Okay. Got it?
Okay. We have 4 minutes left.
Oh my gosh, 4 minutes. Okay. So what we're going to do next is I'm going to turn on a non-stick skillet. I put a bit of oil in here. I like to use neutral oil, like canola oil or vegetable oil. I really don't like to use olive oil because I don't like the nutty flavor. Kind of doesn't mesh well with Asian dishes. So yes. We're going to get this nice and hot on medium-high heat. Okay. I'm like, she's doing great. So the magic with pot stickers is it's kind of crispy on the bottom and it's nice and fluffy on top. Because we pan fry them and then we steam them the rest of the way. So I mean, they're pretty healthy compared to like deep fried
stuff. Oh, for
stuff.
Sure.
So I'm just gonna put this here. And then,
oh wow.
Yeah.
Those are so pretty.
They're so cute. So aren't they so cute?
This is like the ugly delicious.
This is ugly delicious. Some of the ugliest looking things are the most delicious.
Yes.
You know, like octopus, that's delicious.
Yes.
Frog legs, delicious.
We'll make those in the next TSM.
Chicken feet, not so delicious. Okay, so then we let these get nice and golden brown on the bottom. Now, of course, you could deep fry these if you wanted to. You could also just steam them.
I mean, that would be totally healthy. But this is healthy. Deep frying.
But if you like the pan-fried steaming, pan-fried steaming method is just so delicious. Okay, once you get them golden brown, okay, then we add about a half a cup of water. And then we just steam them the rest of the way. Now this is gonna take about 7 or 8 minutes to steam. But through the magic of TV, we happen to have a platter of golden delicious pot stickers that we made for you in advance. I mean, don't you want to just jump out of the screen and eat these? They're so good. Again, this recipe you can find in my cookbook, Everyday Chinese Cookbook, 101 Delicious Recipes for My Mother's Kitchen, $24, including shipping.